हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज सविता पवार. वेलकम टू माय चैनल गेट द मैथ. इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 7.3 ऑफ लेसन 7 ट्रायंगल्स. इन द आई लिंक अबव आई हैव शेयर्ड द वीडियो ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 7.1 एज वेल एज 7.2. ऑल द एक्सप्लेनेशन दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड आई हैव गिवन इन एक्सरसाइज 7.1 एंड 7.2. प्लीज गो थ्रू दैट वीडियो. नाउ द सेम क्वेश्चंस we are going to solve in exercise 7.3. So first question is, triangle ABC and DBC are the two isosceles triangles on the same base BC, and the vertex A and D lie on the same side of BC, and AD is extended to intersect BC at point P. So we have to show that ABD equal to ACD, ABP is equal to ACP, AP bisects A as well as D, and AP is perpendicular bisector to BC. So it is perpendicular, that is this angle is 90 and also this is equal to this. That we have to prove here. So I have written here whatever it is given, that ABC and DBC are isosceles triangle, and AB equal to AC and DB equal to DC. Write all the four points for to prove. Let us start with the proof here. So write in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, you can see here AB equal to AC, then BD equal to CD, and AD is equal to AD. These two are given, and this one is CPCT, and therefore triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD by SSS test. And when it is congruent, so you have to write the CPCT, that BAD equal to angle CAD and angle BDA equal to angle CDA. These both are here CPCT. Which angles? I will show you in the figure with the yellow color, so that this angle equal to this angle and this equal to this. Okay, so these both are equal angles, and therefore you can say that AD or AP bisects. Therefore AP bisects both angle A and angle D. That was asked to prove in the third point here. Now the second one is, in triangle ABP, this triangle you have to consider, in triangle ABP and triangle ACP, right, what is equal? You can see in the figure it is AB equal to AC, angle BAP that we have proved above is equal to angle CAP. It was D, but D can be extended to P, so you can write BA instead of BAD, you can write BAP now. Okay, so this is given, this one is proved above. Then the third one is AP is equal to AP, that is common. Therefore, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP by SAS, side angle side, and therefore you have to write the CPCT. So it will be that this side is equal to this side, and therefore this angle is equal to this angle, that you have to write as CPCT. Therefore BP equal to CP by CPCT, and angle BPA is equal to angle CPA. These both are here CPCT. Now BPC lies in a straight line, so here you can write BPA plus angle CPA equal to 180, since BPC, that is a straight line, so therefore linear pair, LP is linear pair. So in place of BPA, now you can write CPA or otherwise, that is I will write BPA in both the things. So BPA plus BPA equal to 180. So 2 times angle BPA equal to 180. So angle BPA is 180 by 2, that is 90 degree. Therefore, both the angles will be 90 degree. That is BPA equal to angle CPA, both are 90 degree. And since both are 90 degree, therefore AP is perpendicular to BC and AP is perpendicular bisector of BC since BP equal to CP. Okay, so this is perpendicular also. This is perpendicular also and perpendicular bisector since these two sides are equal. So it is called perpendicular bisector. Okay, so this was your question number 1. In question number 2, here AD is altitude, that is 90 degree of isosceles triangle, so AB equal to AC. So that AD bisects BC, so these two sides should be equal, and AD bisects angle A, so these two angles are equal, that we have to show. So write the given, AD is perpendicular to BC and AB equal to AC. AD bisects BC means BD equal to CD. And AD bisects angle A means angle BAD equal to angle CAD. These both things we have to prove. So consider triangle, that is in triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Here AB equal to AC, that is equal to, sorry, AB equal to AC, that is given. Then other thing, this is given, then AD equal to AD, that is common, and angle BDA equal to angle CDA, which is equal to 90, and therefore triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Two sides and angle is SAS, side angle side, and therefore its CPCT will be BD is equal to CD by CPCT and angle BAD equal to angle CAD, that is also by CPCT, both the things are by CPCT, okay, and therefore you can write as AD bisects angle A. Okay, so that means I can show you here. So we have proved that BD equal to CD, and we have also proved that this angle is equal to this angle. Therefore, AD bisects angle A and AD bisects BC also. Okay. Question 3 is, two triangles have been given, ABC and PQR. Here you can see the symbols, AB equal to PQ, AM equal to PN, and BC is equal to QR, it is given. Here AM and PN are the medians of the triangle. So write the given things, that this is equal to this and this is median. So to prove is, you have to prove that triangle ABM, this triangle equal to PQN, and the whole triangle ABC is congruent to whole triangle PQR. Okay, let us start with the solution. Consider these two triangles. In triangle ABM and triangle PQN, okay, or first we can see, we don't know about BM and CM. Okay, let us start with proof now. BC equal to QR, this is given. So if you do half of BC equal to half of QR, why? Because AM and PN are medians. So half of that will be BM equal to QN. This was not given. We have to prove that this is equal to this. The whole length BC equal to QR was given. Now consider the triangle that ABM and triangle PQN. Write the equal things. AB equal to PQ. It is given. This is given. And AM equal to PN, that is also given, and BM equal to QN, proved above. Therefore, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN by SSS. Okay, and therefore by CPCT it will be. For CPCT, it will be angle B is equal to angle Q by CPCT. Now, this angle equal to this angle that we have proved. Now, consider the whole triangle. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, AB equal to PQ, that is given. Angle ABC, that is B angle, and angle PQR, that is Q angle, that we have proved as equal above. So this is proved above. This one is given. You have to write all the reasons, that is very necessary. And BC equal to QR, that is given. So therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by SAS. Okay, and therefore, so what was the question? Okay, that much was the question. No need to write CPCT here. The triangles were asked to be equal. So we have proved that this triangle equal to this triangle. The next question is question 4 here. BE and CF are the two altitudes of triangle ABC. Using RHS congruency, prove that ABC is an isosceles triangle. So to prove ABC is an isosceles triangle, we have to prove that these two sides are equal. AB equal to AC, that we have to prove. So if BE is perpendicular to AC here, so this angle will be 90, and CF is perpendicular to AB, so this angle will be 90, and BE equal to CF, it is given. You can see this figure, and we have to consider these triangles, that is BFC and CEB or EBC. Okay, so here BFC equal to CEB equal to 90, these two are 90, and BE equal to CF, that is given, and BC is common here. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by RHS. Now, how RHS? This is 90 degree. And the side in front of the 90 degree is always hypotenuse. So this is hypotenuse. So right hand side hypotenuse are equal. Therefore it is RHS. Okay. And one side is equal. So therefore it is RHS. Now write the CPCT that FBC. So this full angle FBC equal to ECB. This is equal. This whole angle is equal to this angle. This angle equal to this angle now. And therefore AC will be equal to, if we consider the whole triangle now, AB will be equal to AC, and therefore ABC is an isosceles triangle. For reason, sides opposite to equal angles are equal. That was question 4th. Question 5th is, ABC is an isosceles triangle, AB equal to AC given. Draw AP perpendicular to BC, this means these angles are 90. You have to prove angle B equal to angle C. So ABC isosceles, therefore AB equal to AC. You have to prove B equal to C here. So consider these two triangles now. Here these two are equal. AP is common and these two are equal to 90 degree, it is given already, and therefore the triangles are congruent and therefore B equal to C by CPCT. So this is how you have to solve your exercise 7.3. If you have any query, drop in the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe my channel, Get the Math.